He has told you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you but to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God.
Be merciful, just as your Father is merciful.
Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me.
For the whole law is fulfilled in one word: you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
Jesus said, whoever welcomes a child in my name welcomes me. First thing somebody would notice if they came to visit our church for the first time is that we have a really young church. The majority of the children that come and teenagers, they come without any adults. I think in many places, kids go to church because their family goes to church. But here, the children come to church because the church is their family.
Children's ministry on Sunday is pretty unique. The majority of the congregation is children. 90% of those kids are coming without a parent, so on Sunday, their small group acts as a surrogate parent, and it's a really beautiful picture of the gospel that you got these kids that are living and coming from rough situations, that many of them are functioning as orphans and don't have family that cares for them, and maybe the family does care, but their addiction problems are keeping them from loving the kids like they should, and the church gets to be a parent for a few hours for them. So our Sunday church is very unique, but it's a really beautiful picture of the gospel and a really great picture to see the love of Christ on these kids and changing them as they grow up and know Jesus and learn more about Jesus and follow him.
You're Mr. Fox?
21!
I think the first time we came to Sacred Road was 2010. You know, we were at Kids Club at Totus Park, and the children we played with, initially are now, they were probably grade school back then, are now high school and young adults. It's just been a huge blessing to see them learn to serve, and they're teaching the younger ones. There's a full-fledged church here now. I feel like, you know, we were there in the earlier years when just a Bible study, and it was just hard to visualize what things were going to be like. But here we are, and it's been a huge blessing to be here this week and see that, you know, those kids, they're success stories. They are products of the ministry. God has just blessed it so much, and it's so wonderful to come here to see it firsthand.
So we've been on a lot of mission trips out of the country and in the country, but the thing that's unique about Washington and the Yakama Reservation is, I feel like you get a cross-cultural experience, but you're still in the United States. It's a five-hour plane ride, but it is a completely different culture, completely different people. And I've been on a lot of mission trips before. We went and served at a project and didn't feel like we really got a lot accomplished, but we are just have the ability to do tons of different things and really feel like we're helping the people in the community. And so that's been a real blessing to us. There's been more work than we could even do, but we feel like we've accomplished something by serving them for the Lord. The Yakama people are incredibly welcoming and loving, and so it's been a real neat experience.
Sacred Road is not just preaching to these people. Sacred Road is providing material support and hope. And even if it never results in their salvation, it's showing God's love to the community. I think both through the work projects and the kids club, you can just see the different levels of how the Lord's working through Sacred Road.
I've been able to come to Sacred Road since 2004. I'm not sure who's been affected most by my visits, whether it's the people here or myself. I know I'm not even close to being the same person as I was when I started coming. This has been a life-changing experience for me to be able to share the gospel and interact with people that are honest about their brokenness. At home, people close the door and they put on a nice smile and drive their nice car around and you think everything's fine. The people here are just kind of honest about those kind of things that we're good at hiding.
Appreciate the help that that Chris gives me every year. I just appreciate the kids doing this.
I just want to thank everybody, all of Sacred Road Ministries, for everything you're doing for us. Thank you so very much.
Here in Yakama, there's just a real need for the gospel I've seen, and the people are open to it. It's so great to see how the kids are just so welcoming and loving to everyone. It's just really incredible to see how the Lord's working here.
I feel like the joy of the Lord is just really evident here, especially seen through the kids that I've met this week. Each one of them specifically just has something in their heart that they either want to share with you, give you, or just want to love you. And I think it's just the little things that make these kids happy. And I think that's just so important, because we take so much for granted and we're just so privileged living in places that we just are so used to. And these kids, they have so little, yet they have, like, everything is so much to them. That's something that's just been encouraging to me, because they've really shown me the love of Christ and how to be a better Christian.
The kids here, they already love you because they know you're with the church, and they just already trust you and they love you. And there's something about, like, the innocence of just getting there and seeing all these kids who they've never seen me in their life and they don't know me at all. But they just come, jump on my back, jump into my arms, want me to play with them, want me to carry them around because I'm with the church. So that's going to keep them coming back to the church. That's going to keep them really in good hands here, growing up to walk with the Lord. And that's the first step towards a revival.